Amen.
I would like to share with you a true story. There was a girl who was very sick, and she needed a blood transfusion. Her little 5-year-old brother had the same illness, but miraculously was able to overcome it on his own without any medication. But she wasn't able to overcome it. So there was a need for a blood transfusion from little boy to his older sister. So his father came to him and told him, "Will you give blood to your sister so that she can heal?" And the little 5-year-old boy hesitated for a moment and said, "Okay, if it will save her, I will give her my blood." So it was time to do the blood transfusion. They sat on the same bed in the hospital, and the doctor started the blood transfusion from him to her. As the blood transfusion was taking place, her color returned to her. She started to feel better, because her little brother has already developed the antibodies for this problem. And she was getting his antibodies that were saving her. After blood transfusion was ending, the boy looked to his father and said, "What happened, Berkeley? I uttered some amazing words that got everybody crying." Brothers and sisters in Christ, today's gospel reading talks about giving, about sharing what we have with others. You see, none of us is poor. Now, I don't mean you are millionaires, but none of us is destitute. None of us doesn't have a place to sleep. None of us does not have clothing to wear. Every one of us has food to eat every day, a roof over our heads. None of us is poor in that sense. Actually, orthodoxy requires every one of us to have a certain amount of love. No, I'm not talking about millions or hundreds of thousands of dollars. I'm talking about a minimal amount of love that we must have. Even monks and nuns have a certain amount of love. They have a bed, they have a table to eat at, they have a lamp, they have a book. That's some sort of love. Because without this minimum amount of love, we cannot really be Christians. We cannot exercise our Christianity. Because we have no choices. You see, at the beginning, God gave all of us